we worship you, ya Allah. We say to Allah, we worship you and we seek your help. And I find most of us, alhamdulillah, worship Allah. We say, la ilaha illallah, there is no God but Allah. But seeking our help, the help, we put our faith more in human. How many of us all the time seek the help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So we have taken this ayah, this verse, and divided it in half. The worship, alhamdulillah, we worship Allah. But the help, we say this is a dunya, and we seek help from humans. And there's nothing wrong with seeking help from humans if we know that everything comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's where it says, إِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. We seek Allah's help in everything we do. It's very important aspect. So when we read Al-Fatiha in our prayers, we should focus on we worship Allah and we seek help from Allah. So next time we need anything, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala first. And sometimes we think something is going to be hard and we go and we say, I met somebody who made it easy. Yes, we met somebody who made it easy, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala inspired this person to help you. It all starts from Allah. So when we need help, we raise our hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It reminds me, a man went to ask Umar ibn al-Khattab, the second successor of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Khalifa, and he found Umar in the masjid raising his hand to Allah and saying, Ya Allah. And the man says, I got embarrassed. I got embarrassed because here I am going to ask him for something and I found him asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I decided to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala myself rather than asking Umar. And another man always used to come to Umar for help. Again, I need this, I need this. And Umar, being the governor and teaches us, he was always listening to everybody for their needs and taking care of their needs. So this Muslim came one day to Umar, and Umar told him, why don't you read the book of Allah? Read the Quran and you'll find your answers. And this man disappeared for a while. He stopped coming to Umar again. So Umar met him one time in the market and told him, I have not seen you for a while. You have not come to see me, visit me for a while. What happened? He said, well, you guided me. You put me back to the book of Allah. When I read it, I found the answer to everything I need. So now when I want to ask, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I don't need to come and ask you, Umar. And subhanallah, you know, why is it easy for us to ask humans when we know humans are moody? Sometimes they're in a good mood, sometimes they're in a bad mood, sometimes they are in a position to help. Sometimes they're not, even though they might want to help, they cannot help. So why do we put ourselves in this position rather than ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And Fizas Altfas Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ ادْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, ask, pray to me, and I will give you. Subhanallah. Pray and I will give you. And yet we don't put our faith in Allah and we put the faith in humans. And putting the faith in human, just like this verse says, is like depending on a spider web, something that's weak, something that cannot really protect themselves, let alone protect or help you or provide help. So inshallah, let's reflect on this and let's inshallah, when we need help and we seek help, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, inshallah. We have to go for a break and we'll carry on with reflecting on the Quran when we come back. Please help us keep the show on the air. We need your donations. We need your help. Please go visit the website and donate or send us a check. And I would encourage everyone who comes up to me and say, I love your show. Please send us a check and help keep the show on the air. Assalamu alaikum and welcome back to Spirit of Islam. Today we're talking about a topic that's very close to my heart, which is reflection on some of the verses of the Quran. And you know, they really, when you read the Quran and you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking to you, and this is the true miracle of the Quran. It was kept throughout time for Allah to talk to each and every one of us. That's why I encourage people to read the Quran. One of the ayat that really touched me is it describes the scene where Prophet Solomon had sent the Hudhud, one of the birds, the hoopoe, to find out about a village that worship somebody other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this bird comes back and tells Prophet Sulaiman, Prophet Solomon, I have found people who bow to the sun. They don't bow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the amazing thing is this bird asks a simple question. Why do they bow to the sun rather than bowing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who brings their food out of earth? And he described the bring the worms, because here, as we know, the birds, when they fly, they see the worms and they come and pick it up. And they know it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who brings it out of earth. So this bird is wondering, look at these people bowing to somebody other than Allah when it is Allah who's bringing the food. The bird knew the simple fact of life, that food does not come out by itself. Subhanallah. It is God who inspires onto things to come out and created it this way. So he says, why do they bow for the sun or something else when they don't bow to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Even the bird, in his simple logic, is teaching us. And that's why I say we have to learn from the birds. And Allah, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, if we observe Allah as we should, we will be like the birds. We go out in the morning hungry and we come back full. The birds, when they leave their nests in the morning, they rely on Allah. They say, Tawakkaltu ala Allah, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala supplies for them. And whether he